After Darth Vader was defeated by Obi-Wan Kenobi, despite seemingly being sympathetic at first, his master Darth Sidious was furious with his performance on Mustafar. At the same time though, he was somewhat impressed with Anakin Skywalker's, now Darth Vader's, performance just following. Sidious was extremely impressed that Skywalker was still alive, despite severe burns covering his entire body and the loss of all of his remaining limbs. And still, Skywalker had used the dark side of the Force and his hatred for Kenobi and the Jedi to cling to life. After being transferred to Palpatine's personal shuttle, Darth Sidious would take over duties of using the dark side of the Force to keep Vader alive. Darth Sidious would utilize a dark side ritual that he had practiced many times before on himself to keep Vader stable for the time being. However, once Vader had returned to Coruscant and Palpatine was assured that he would in fact survive, Palpatine ordered something cruel upon his apprentice. When the medical droids took Vader into the facility, Palpatine gave them one order. That order was to keep him alive, but also to keep him awake. Darth Sidious did this with two motives in mind. If Vader was awake, first, he would feel the dark side of the Force flow through his body as he never had before. Pain is one of the key motivators for the dark side, and ironically, as a Sith Lord grows in pain, they also grow in power in the dark side of the Force. The other reason though, of course, was because of punishment. Sidious, in fact, wanted to punish Vader even further. Darth Sidious wanted Vader to feel every prod and cut of the knife. He wanted him to understand just how badly he had failed on his first showing as a Sith Lord. As the medical droid scrubbed away his now burning dead flesh, Vader felt everything. As they attached the jugged cybernetics to his now stump of arms and legs, he was conscious during it all. The dark side of the Force, just as Sidious had wanted, flowing through him like he had never experienced before. In truth, this would mark Darth Vader's first lesson. This would mark the moment that Anakin Skywalker finally faded into the being known as Darth Vader. Despite all of the physical pain though, the psychological damage was far more impactful on the Sith Lord. As he laid there for what seemed to him like weeks, he wondered if his wife was okay. He wondered if Padme had made it out alive, or, in his rage, if he had in fact killed her. No one spoke to Vader, as that was again another order on behalf of Palpatine. Darth Sidious wanted his apprentice to wonder what had become of his wife. If Vader had been kept alive, none of this would have happened, and he never would have experienced the great connection to the dark side of the Force that he did. A connection, though, that would last him the rest of his life, as the pain never subsided. In fact, the cybernetics made it even worse, as it would catch on Vader's limbs. It was on that surgical table that Anakin Skywalker died and Darth Vader emerged, a process that would have taken much longer if Palpatine had simply allowed Vader sleep. But that is why the Sith Master Darth Sidious ordered his apprentice to be kept awake during his entire procedure, and why ultimately this proved to be beneficial for Lord Vader. But leave your own thoughts on this in the comments down below, and did you know about this little factoid before this video? Before you go, be sure to check out my other channel, The Marvelous Wave, where we talk all about the Marvel Cinematic Universe, including news, breakdowns, and theories about all upcoming and past Marvel movies. Link to the channel is in the description below. Thank you guys, as always, so much for watching. May the Force be with you, and have a great day.